Hello, this is Dr. Charles Hawker. In this presentation, I will be describing the invention of an automated system to detect mislabeled specimens. Every laboratory has mislabeled specimens. At ARUP, the average rate in our specimen processing department is one mislabeled specimen per 8,000 specimens processed. This is much lower than the 1 per 1,000 or 2,000 that has been published based on CAP surveys. Nevertheless, we felt it important to detect and prevent every mislabeled specimen, if possible. So in 2005, we began to investigate the possibility of an automated high-speed camera system that could use optical character recognition technology, or OCR, to identify mislabeled specimens. Over the ensuing 8 years, we developed and validated such a system. A manuscript describing this invention was published in the March 2014 issue of the journal Clinical Chemistry, and it was accompanied by an editorial by Dr. Robin Felder of the University of Virginia, one of the world's most renowned automation experts. This video clip shows the operation of the system that was developed to detect mislabeled specimens. As shown in this scene, specimens are being transported in carriers on our automation system. They are stopped at a precise point, enabling a robot to pick the tubes out of the carrier and lift them up to the vision system. This stopping point is directly in front of a red backlight, and with the aid of a 45-degree mirror, a smart camera, which is shown in the right foreground, measures the tube's height and the diameter of the cap. This enables the robot to securely grasp the cap and lift the tube. This view shows more of the entire system. The robot is on the right. On the left is the operator's computer screen, which shows each image as it is acquired and the results of the OCR analysis. In this view, of course, all protected health information has been blurred so that it can't be read. However, you can see the screen change to a new image as each tube is photographed and analyzed. The cycle time for one tube ranges from 2.5 to 3.5 seconds, depending on the quality of the label. This view again shows the transport carriers with tubes arriving at the stopping point where the robot will lift them to the vision system. On the left you can see the 45-degree mirror that the smart camera uses to measure the tube's dimensions to guide the robot in correctly picking up the tube by its cap. This view from the top shows the robot and vision system. There are four equally spaced cameras with four reflective panels and four strobe lights. As you can see from this pause in the video, the strobe lights are very bright. The vision system software precisely stitches the four separate photographs into a single photograph, which is the entire exterior of the tube and is so sharp that OCR can be performed. This slide shows an example of a pass image. The larger upper photograph with blue background is the actual compiled image of the entire tube exterior, made by stitching together the four separate photographs taken by the four cameras. The ARUP label is in the lower part of the photograph, and the customer's label is in the upper part. The smaller gray and white photograph appearing below is a crop out of the larger photograph. It contains just the portion of the image outside of the ARUP label. In other words, the cropped image is only the customer's label. The customer transmitted to our LIS a patient name of Test, Jody, DND, and also printed that name on the label. The vision system used the barcode on the ARUP label to learn what patient name was associated in the LIS with that barcode, which was also Test, Jody, DND. The OCR engine in the vision system then searched the customer's label to see if there was a matching character string. There was, so the vision system declared a pass. This slide, on the other hand, shows an example of a fail image. The customer transmitted a patient name test, DTS4587, and also printed it on their label. In our LIS record, however, we intentionally changed the name to test, DTS4588. As expected, the OCR system could not find the matching name and declared the image as a fail. This example illustrates that the OCR system works with both alphabetic and numeric characters. The OCR system can also rotate the image by 180 degrees when the labels are oriented in that direction. ARUP is very proud of this invention, of an automated system for detection of possible mislabeled specimens. All fail images are not necessarily mislabeled. Images can fail because of the poor quality of client labels or other reasons. However, when multiple OCR systems are fully implemented on our automation, all fail images will route to a station where they will be inspected by an employee. Most of these will be found to be correctly labeled, even though the OCR system could not declare them as passes. The few that are found at this station to be mislabeled will be promptly investigated and relabeled. So, what can our clients do to assure that their specimens will be analyzed and passed by this new OCR system? Specimen labels that fail the OCR analysis generally fail because of the formats, fonts, and locations of the patient name on the client labels. The Clinical and Laboratory Standards Institute, or CLSI, published a standard, AUTO 12A, in April of 2011 to address this problem. The standard was developed by a large consensus committee in order to lower the high incidence of mislabeled specimens in the U.S. Both the CAP and the Joint Commission have indicated their interest in adding this standard to checklists within 1 to 2 years. We hope our clients appreciate the true value of this OCR system to the quality of the laboratory testing they receive from ARUP. Our goal is to drive our error rate for mislabeled specimens, already much better than that in most laboratories, to near zero levels. To us, the only acceptable error rate is zero. We also hope our clients understand the value of the new CLSI standard in their own operations. Many hospitals receive labeled specimens from affiliated hospitals, clinics, and doctors' offices. Often these labels are not tied to the laboratory's LIS system and must be relabeled, thus creating the possibility of mislabeled specimens. Thanks for watching this video about the OCR system.